Joining me now is Forrester Vice President and Principal Analyst Dave Bartoletti. Dave leads Forrester's Cloud Computing Playbook team, and he's been helping companies accelerate their journey to the cloud for more than a decade. Welcome, Dave.
Thank you for having me.
So good to be here. Fantastic. Now, as I was saying early, the majority of organizations are really taking this hybrid cloud approach. Mm-hmm. And in my experience in working with customers, I've seen them largely shift from just thinking about it as a half step to really thinking about this as a durable approach. And I'd love to hear what you're seeing in working with clients.
Absolutely. Hybrid cloud used to be something that happened to companies, right? The business was so desperate to use public cloud services, and IT organizations were really desperate to get the benefits of cloud for infrastructure that remained in the data center. So many clients started migrating workloads to public cloud, looking for some cost savings initially, and also trying to build a private cloud themselves. Right? But the on-prem clouds didn't work that well with the public cloud, and they found out that just moving without modernizing didn't get enough of an initial benefit. So we find over and over again that something needs to get better about an application before you move it to any cloud platform, whether it's public, private, or hybrid.
So what do you think's behind driving this, you know, shift of thinking about it from lift and shift into innovation?
Well, first, cloud is no longer a place to get cheap infrastructure. I like to say it's no longer even a place. Right? It's shorthand for all the tools and services we're going to use to build better apps faster. My client sees cloud now as a set of building blocks. They want to use the building blocks wherever they can, in their preferred public cloud, in their data center, or even at the edge. And it used to just be much harder to build a private cloud, a true cloud platform that looks and acts like a public cloud. That's changed. Getting cloud services into developer hands faster, we're seeing people release software 3, 4, 5 times faster than they did before.
Wow.
It lets people get to that new data insight from all the wonderful customer data we're collecting from new mobile and web apps. And it lets people build and test new ideas without worrying up front about where they're going to run. What we keep finding over and over again is speed is not just something that we all think sounds great, right? Companies that move faster create better customer experiences, and companies that have better customer experience make more money. That's the top line benefit in revenue, and you can use that new revenue to feed back in and expand the use of your investment in hybrid cloud.
I see. So it kind of goes full circle
exactly.
In that way. Now, one of the other things I see is customers moving into hybrid cloud, also adopting DevOps.
Yep.
And you talk about the speed and agility, and it's great to see them really put those hand in hand versus just think about cloud and then have a different process and really be able to iterate and listen to those customers quickly.
That's right.
And be more agile.
And I think that it's all about being intentional in how you design your hybrid cloud environment so that the hybrid cloud doesn't happen to you. Automation is at the core. There is no cloud without automation, I like to say as well.
Okay.
What you need to do is design the best mix of development, data, and infrastructure services. So remember, you can modernize both apps and infrastructure at the same time. You don't have to take two separate paths to cloud value anymore. You don't have to reinvent cloud in each new place. What you can do is today take advantage of all the exciting machine learning, database, Internet of Things, all these great new innovative technologies that are being pioneered and proven in the public cloud. You can now get them in the data center. What hybrid cloud means is it lets you get access to innovations faster in more places and as close as possible to your customers.
Absolutely makes sense. Now, what would you say are kind of the top benefits you see across the many, many customers you work with of having this well-designed, intentional hybrid cloud strategy?
Absolutely. Fundamentally, hybrid is an accelerator now. It's not a half step. It's not something I do before I get completely to public cloud. It lets me move faster, and speed is king. A well-designed hybrid strategy frees your developers from having to worry about where when they should be worrying about how. How are we going to build a better experience? They can test on premises. They can deploy in the public cloud. It should let you leverage all the infrastructure skills you have today. And you should make sure you focus on consistent developer and operations experiences everywhere. That's the key. Really, what hybrid cloud is about is not reinventing the wheel everywhere I want cloud innovation.
Right, absolutely. And really, to get the benefit of all those cloud services, you need to think about whether you have the right tools for the developer, like, are the tools integrated? Are those DevOps tools kind of part of like that automation pipeline process?
That's right.
Right, and then make sure that you're really taking that full asset. I mean, developers are these very scarce resources these days. So are you kind of making sure that they're being as productive as possible? Now, you talked about your advice to be very intentional about your hybrid cloud. How do you think your customers should evaluate the solutions to meet their needs, both today but also tomorrow?
Sure. So what's really rising to the top is consistency. It's probably the most important feature of any hybrid cloud solution today, and I mean consistent tools. I need consistent APIs. You mentioned developers. They want consistent APIs wherever they're working. And consistent developer experience, that means tight integration with DevOps tooling. Mm-hmm. So right at the end of a DevOps pipeline, cloud deployment is an option, and it's right there. Okay. It has to support portability. That means move compute as close as possible to data, customer-facing apps as close as possible to the customer, or it might mean pushing something out to an edge device. But I think the third thing really is, with all this consistency and portability, no one's going to move anything to a platform they don't trust. So always at the top of our requirements list is consistent security. That doesn't mean just consistent security policies, but it means rock-solid data protection, whether you're doing it in public cloud or on-prem.
Got it. I mean, you're ultimately trying to protect that data, right? So essential on that front. Now, in talking to some customers around their hybrid cloud, some of the pain points is around talent and people and skills. And this is actually a global issue, right? I mean, and right here, even in the US, we know we have incredible shortage, like 6 million job openings and not enough people to with the skills to fill those jobs. So this is a very real world issue for many of the clients you work with. What's your advice?
Everywhere you and I work, it's an incredible challenge. And in the largest technology centers, especially in North America, you're competing not only with your competitors in your industry, but you're competing with technology companies for that talent. There's no question it's really tough to find cloud-savvy talent. So what we tell people is that you have to make an investment in your current teams. You have to invest in training, new cloud skills, cloud platforms, cloud automation. But if you have to keep retraining your teams for a different public cloud and a different private platform and a different edge platform, you're going to slow yourself down. You're going to lose that that speed edge. So the key is always to look for ways to extend what folks already know, whether it's how to build something cloud native in a public platform, extend those skills into the data center, whether it's managing on-premises infrastructure and optimizing that with cloud platforms, extend that into the public cloud. That's really the key.
It's so smart. And frankly, the only way, you know, our customers can be able to do this effectively of having durability across in those ways. Well, Dave, thank you so much. This has been a fantastic conversation. I really appreciate your insights and the wisdom that you've gained working with so many customers. Thank you for being here.
Thank you so much for having me.